boeken, 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 boeken. Het is weer tijd voor de boekenbe... Of niet dit jaar?
Het is online.
Een online boekenbeurs.
Met streamende schrijvers.
Stromende woorden.
Een feest in digitalere ogen.
Vaste waarde.
Debutante.
Bubbellectuur, zelfs pikante.
Boeken beleven kan altijd.
Want fantasie is virusvrij.
Hier zijn we, zie. Je kijkt naar de Boekenmarathon 2020. Het langste en ook wel gekste en meest gevarieerde boekenprogramma dat er ooit gemaakt is in Vlaanderen en Nederland. Wij zijn daar super trots op. Maar tegelijkertijd zitten wij allemaal te hopen dat het maar één keer moet. Dat we volgend jaar terug van je boekenbeurs kunnen doen. En dat we hier gewoon zelf met onze vieze, vuile pollen aan boeken kunnen komen zitten. Want daar draait het hier toch een klein beetje om. Dat we kennis kunnen maken met al die auteurs en illustrators en uitgevers. Dat kan dit jaar niet, maar dat wil niet zeggen dat er geen prachtige boeken worden uitgegeven. De oogst van 2020, daar gaan we doorheen. Om het kwartier een ander boek, een andere kaft die we openslaan en een andere wereld die voor ons opengaat. Het is te zeggen, misschien is deze wereld al wel eens voor jou open gegaan, want het is het volgende stuk uit een reeks. De reeks Warrior Cats heeft een nieuwe worp. Ja, het is ook een boek, maar ik heb alleen maar dit kartonnetje gekregen. Dit heeft een nieuwe aflevering gekregen. Het ontstaan van de Clans. De felle ster. Dat wordt geschreven door Erin Hunter. Maar Erin Hunter, die bestaat eigenlijk niet. Erin Hunter bestaat uit verschillende andere mensen. Onder andere uit, uit deze fantastische dame die ik hier aan de lijn heb, van ergens aan de andere kant van de wereld. Kate Carey, hi, nice to meet you.
Hiya, hello. Nice Kate, to meet you too.
Kate, where am I calling you? In what part of the UK are you?
I'm in Sheffield, which is north, South Yorkshire.
The beautiful Sheffield, which we all know and should visit sometime. Not now, but
definitely. It's very lovely.
Kate, just to explain to people that know the books, the Warrior Cats books by Erin Hunter. Erin Hunter actually doesn't exist. Who is Erin Hunter?
Erin Hunter is a team of people. We have an editorial team and they come up with the storylines, and then there are various writers. So for Warriors, the cats, me and Cherith Baldry, we write books. So the editorial team come up with the storylines, and then me and Cherith take it in turns to write the books. But Erin Hunter's written other series about called Bravelands and Survivors and Seekers, and they're yet other Erin Hunters. So it sort of encompasses a lot of writers and editors who are working very hard to come up with some interesting stories.
It's a beautiful, beautiful project. The Warrior Cats, for people that don't know them, who are they, and what happened in the existing books before this one?
We're on our seventh series now, so they've been they've been through a lot, our cats. They're basically they're wild cats. So they live in the wild, which the first book was called Into the Wild, and it started out with a house cat, a sort of domesticated cat, who went out into the back garden and beyond the back garden fence one day, and met some wild cats and kind of joined them, and then he was inducted into clan life. So all these cats live in clans. There's five clans, and they sort of fight over territory, and they all follow the warrior code, and they share ancestors, and they've got their whole a whole sort of social system going on there that's quite complex. It gets more complex with every series.
It's an entire universe filled with cats. So for all you cat people out there,
we've got over 1,000 named characters at the moment. So there's a lot
1,000.
Of cats. Yeah.
And who keeps track of them all?
Oh, we all try our best, but actually we rely a lot on our readers to keep track. There are a lot of fan sites out there that we actually sneak onto and have a look and go, oh, thank you for remembering that cat, because we'd forgotten all about them. And so our fans really help us out by keeping very close track of them.
When you join the project, do you have to do like an exam about all those cats, about all those characters?
I don't know. I'm lucky because I wrote the first two books ever, so I started 18 years ago. So I've been at it for 18 years, and even I don't know all the cats. I get so confused.
You started when it was easy, when it was still easy.
That was just like, you know, 20, 30 cats. It was simple.
And so now in a new part of the Warrior Cats universe, you explore the origin of the different clans. Each clan gets its own book, or how does it work?
Well, we tend to sort of, a book will be the adventures of all the clans together, and we started off just from the viewpoint of one clan. They were the ones we followed, but now these days we do it from different viewpoints of different clans. So there'll be sort of Thunder Clan telling the story, part of the story, and then you get part of the story from Shadow Clan. And they used to always fight each other, but nowadays they more work together and fight some outside force, and they're always fighting somebody.
So for all those who are interested in the origins of the Thunder Clan, the River Clan, the Wind Clan, and so on, they will discover everything about them.
Yes, because we sort of, the first series was when Firestar joined them. Then after about, I think the third, fourth series, we went back to the origins of the clans. So we went right back to the very beginning of how the clans were formed and, you know, where they came from. And, it's been an exciting adventure. So, yeah, if you read all the series, you'll find out exactly how the clans formed in the first place and up to where they are now.
That's incredible. A really beautiful project, and it has lots of success, not only in England, but abroad, in Belgium too. What is your typical Warrior Cat reader?
I don't know. We aim the stories at 8 to 12 year olds, but we have so many readers, like adult readers, I'm always surprised, and we get a lot of, it's mainly girls, I suppose, but we get a lot of boys who read it too, because there's a lot of adventure and sort of fighting, and it's, I don't know what you describe a Warriors reader. They're quite like me, they're kind of a bit geeky and a bit thoughtful and very, very creative, and it's amazing what our fans kind of do, the drawings they create and the fan fiction they create, they're amazing, yeah, so... I think it's the creative types, young kids,
The team behind Erin Hunter, how big is the team? How many are you?
Working particularly on Warriors, there's me and Cherith Baldry with the writers for the series, and we have a team of editors with, I think it's three or four editors who come up with the storylines, and there's sort of six of us really.
Yeah. It's a beautiful but rather atypical way of working. How are the tasks divided? How do you work usually?
I think the editors work closer together, although some of them are based in England and some are based in America, but they work closely and they work really hard to develop a very detailed storyline. And they sort of take a few months doing that, and once they've done it, they'll send me the storyline and I'll just write the novel from the storyline. And I work very much on my own. So the sort of the editors work together, but I think me and Cherith both work quite sort of on our own. Once we've got the storyline, we just... turn it into sort of a book that somebody would love to read.
Really, really nice. Are you a cat person yourself? That's a question you always get. I guess.
Yeah. I think that's why I was asked to try out for the series, because I wrote on my sort of CV, I love cats. So they go, oh, well, try writing for this book. Go, yeah, okay. But yeah, I'm very much a cat person. I've always had cats.
Inspirational cats all around you. Is this also kind of an exercise in seeing your own cat walking through the garden or to the living room and thinking about all the secrets that are in the cat's head and the secret life of cats outside?
I wish that were true, but the warrior cats are a lot cleverer than the cats I've ever had. My cats really don't think about anything apart from sleeping or eating. I was worried that if my cats had to face all the things that the warrior cats had to face, I would worry for them, because they wouldn't be up to the task at all.
The universe of your Warrior Cats is really, really huge. More than 1,000 characters and lots of books, dozens of books. How huge can it get? Is there an end to it, or will you just keep on going as long as people want to read it?
I think we'll keep on going because it's just fun. I mean, it's just fun writing cat adventures. I love doing it. So, but I can't imagine stopping. There's always something new to write about and a new adventure. And we take it into sort of all kinds of fantastical realms. So, yeah. Mm. I've just finished writing
Sorry. Just keep on talking. Thank you.
I just finished writing a first draft that takes it into all kinds of dark places that we've never been before. It's like very exciting. So I don't think we're going to run out of ideas anytime soon.
Are there any Warrior Cats movies coming up or TV series? I would like to see it.
There's been a movie in the pipeline for years now, but it's not really got anywhere. I don't know how far it is, whether it's actually going to happen. And there's talk of that if the movie doesn't happen, perhaps we'll develop as a TV series. We certainly want to get it on the screen because it's such good stories. And I think, I think we've got a lot of people wanting to see it. So, yeah, hopefully in the future sometime.
These are well, rather trying times for all of us, but I can imagine that you work from home and this series just continues. Did anything in the past couple of months change in the way you've been working?
No, I'm afraid that as a writer, kind of my life hasn't changed very much at all. So yeah, I'm very lucky that working from home has not been much difference, really.
You just keep on going. Working on the first draft of a new cat story. Is there other stuff on your desk too, or is this a dedication to only this project?
No, I've been working on my own book of gothic chiller that I'm looking for a publisher at the moment that I really enjoyed writing. It was really exciting. So I'm working on my own things. I think, yeah, I've got an idea next for some horror stories for younger readers. That should be fun.
Looking forward to it. You like exciting, rather darkish kind of stories, don't you?
Well, I like dark things. I must admit, my own life is very dull, so it's good exploring some darker themes.
It's not as dull as you think. You're having a video call with Belgium.
That's true. Yeah, yeah. Although this is the most exciting thing I've done all year.
I don't believe a word you're saying. Final question. Final question, Kate Carey from Erin Hunter and the Warrior Cat books. There are more than 1,000 cats in your universe, but you have to pick one. What's your favorite?
Oh, that's easy. Greystripe. Love Greystripe.
Greystripe.
he's Firestar's best friend. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
You have to read when you will love Greystripe too. He's just lovely.
I will, and we all will. Thank you so much for coming on, and keep on writing. We're enjoying them, and as long as you keep writing them together with the team, brilliant. Will you say hi to the rest of the Erin Hunter team from us?
Oh, hello, Erin Hunters! Thank you so much.
Bye, bye,
and love working with you.
And just forward this video to them, and then they will get your greetings. Thank you so much. Take care there in Sheffield, and wij gaan lezen de Warrior Cats, het ontstaan van de clans, de felle. Dat is de volledige titel van dat nieuwe boek. Dat is gedistribueerd door Bakens en uitgegeven door Fantoom in België, en dus geschreven door het team Erin Hunter. Alle info op boekenbeurs.be, daar vind je alles terug wat je nodig hebt. En ook het adres van je lokale boekhandel. Zo kan je het daar gaan halen voor jezelf of voor iemand die je kent. En kunnen we met z'n allen blijven lezen.